and children were fleeing the Russian army. Now Russian men are fleeing their own military. Vladimir Putin's partial mobilization has caused a general panic in Russia. This was the queue on Russia's border with Georgia. No food, drinks or toilets. This man took 5 days to cross to Georgia. I had to abandon my car, he said. It's been a marathon. Ilya queued for 60 hours. I only had 4 hours sleep. Now I want to put myself into a washing machine. And then he pulled out a Polaroid. I want to live, to see my daughter grow up. Nobody I spoke with said they supported this war, but until now they hadn't dared to speak out.
Everyone understands the reason we're here is because of the man in the Kremlin. Gosh, they'll kill me for that. But it doesn't matter anymore. We're safe. And the main thing is we don't have to kill anybody.
The people that are coming through are exhausted, hungry, sleep deprived. In most cases, people had to spend days in the queue, but they're relieved. They have reached safety. They have avoided the risk of being killed on a battlefield in Ukraine.
Today, downtown Tbilisi, Georgia's capital, feels like little Moscow. It didn't happen overnight. The Russian exodus began even before the war, as repressions grew. But since last week's mobilization, the number of Russians entering Georgia peaked at more than 10,000 a day. And they can stay here without a visa for up to a year. They're opening bank accounts and queuing for local SIM cards. Opposition politicians are urging the government to end this open-door policy.
It's a great security concern, first of all, if we have large numbers of the Russian citizens basically settling down here permanently. Using the force and using the Russian army to protect Russian citizens in the foreign lands and the foreign countries is the right, constitutional right of the Russian Federation. We all understand that the Russians are, in a sense, weaponizing their citizens.
Georgian activists picketed the border this week to remind the new arrivals about their own war with Russia in 2008 over South Ossetia. 20% of Georgian territory is still occupied by Russian forces. Georgians stand with Ukraine. Hundreds of them have volunteered to fight there, and more than a dozen have made the ultimate sacrifice. People feel very strongly here that Russians who came to Georgia have a job to do back home.
If the Russian citizens today are unhappy, as they should be, with their government, I very much hope that they will make their voices heard in their own country.
But put that to the new Russians in exile, many of them middle-class educated professionals like Vadim, and they will tell you that resistance in today's Russia is futile.
There is a huge repressive machine. There is an internal riot police, Rosguardia, of like 400K people, almost 500,000 people, who are trained to suppress protests. And any political organization that was still present in Russia, they got destroyed, their finance was cut, their leaders were put in jails. I don't see how anyone in Russia can affect the situation, how they can fight the regime. Regime put like 10 years of repressive legislation to make it not possible. It was like a long game for them.
There's no going back for these new arrivals while this war continues. In Russia, they were willing to live with the war or ignore it until the call for mobilization came. Now, they will be reminded of it wherever they go.